आई गेस इट्स विजिबल नाउ.
यस सर.
सर
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम. सो yesterday we have stopped at a point where I have explained the number systems, right? Decimal number systems, binary number systems, hexadecimal number systems, octal number systems, and other systems with base 5, right? So today let's start in detail with binary number systems, with binary number systems. And you can see application of binary number systems. I have listed here a few things, right? They are commonly used in programming, right? And these binary numbers are used to instruct the computers. Okay, computers will understand these binary things. So whatever we would like to do or program, okay, we will be programming using this binary numbers so that computers will understand, right? So let's see what arithmetic operations are possible in binary. Like in decimal, we have these four arithmetic operations, right? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, right? So similarly, what these things are possible, I mean arithmetic operations are possible in binary number systems, we will analyze one by one. So addition is possible, subtraction is possible, multiplication is possible, division is possible. So we are comfortable with the decimal number systems. Now today we will see in if the number system is binary and we have two things in the alphabet, 1 and 0, then how to add them, how to subtract them, how to multiply them, and how to divide them, right? So let's see these rules you're supposed to remember, okay? If you have a pen and paper, you can make a note, okay, of this particular table, what I will be using to solve few problems, okay? Addition, let's say we are taking two inputs, A and B, okay, two values are there. So if you add 0 and 0, what will be the sum? 0. And what will be the carry? Carry will be also 0. If you take 0 and 1, the sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. If you take 1 and 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. If you take 1 and 1, okay, 1 and 1, the sum is 0 and carry is 1. Okay, so let me explain. We'll move to I'm given an heading binary systems. Okay, before stepping into the arithmetic, let's understand the conversion process again where we have stopped yesterday. Let's say you have a binary number 1011, okay, and what is its equivalent decimal number? How to know what is its equivalent decimal number if it is base 10? Okay, how to write? So what we were doing yesterday is we were writing this 1 into 2 power 0, okay, plus this 1 into 2 power 1 plus this 0, okay, 0 into 2 power 2, okay, plus this 1 is 1 into 2 power 3, right? And we were getting the answer. It was 8, okay, plus 0, plus this is 2 plus 1, okay, 8 to 10 plus 1, 11. So the answer here was 11, okay? Right. So in short, how we can find it? Right. In short, how we can find it? Yes, it's stuck. Right. It's 11. Right. So in short, how we can find it? Let's see. Formula 1, 2, 4, 8. What are these things? These are two powers. Okay. 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, right? 2 to the power 2. This is 2 power 0. Okay. 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4. Okay. So these things I have noted here. This is 32, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's say I'm writing one 6-digit binary number. Okay, 010110. So what is its decimal equivalent? How to find? What is its decimal equivalent? How to find? So let's say this is 1, means you have to add. This is 1, means you have to add 16 plus 4 plus 2. Okay, 16, 4, 20, 22. The answer is 22. Right? In short. Right. So you have to remember this 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 formula to quickly estimate the value of corresponding decimal numbers. Right? So let's take another example. Okay, let's take another example. If I write, one zero zero one one one. Okay, so what is its equivalent decimal thing? So this is 32 plus 4, 36 plus 2, 38 plus 1, 39. Answer is 39. All of you clear?
Can you explain the process once again?
Sir, can you zoom out, sir? I think you zoomed in. It's looking, it's unclear, sir, the video.
Video is visible, right, properly in system.
So the video, but it's getting stuck, sir. It's getting stuck at a point and it's fast forwarding, so that is not clear, sir.
Okay, there is some net issue, I guess. Let me see. Okay, again we will say, right.
Sir, can you explain the 1632 formula once again, sir, just for clarification?
Yeah, I guess the screen is visible now. Okay.
Yes, sir. It's visible now, sir.
Let's see. 2 power 0. Okay. 2 power 1. 2 power 2. 2 power 3. 2 power 4. 2 power 5. Okay. What is 2 power 0? It's 1. This is 2. This is 4. This is 8. This is 16. This is 30. Similarly, next you will get 64. 2 power 6 will be 64. Okay. Now, these things you have to remember. We call it 1248 formula. Okay. So, let's say I have given a 6-digit binary number. It's 100101. Okay. So, what is its equivalent decimal value? This binary number is given. What is its equivalent decimal value? So, by the conventional method, what we have studied yesterday, what you would have done is, this last one multiplied with 2 power 0, this multiplied with 2 power 0, plus this multiplied with 2 power 2, this multiplied with 2 power 5, you have given the answer. Okay. But now directly how we can find? It is 100101. So here 1 means what? See, this is 32 plus 4 plus 1. Okay. 32 plus 4 plus 1. So how much? 32 plus 4 is 36. Okay. 36 plus 1 is 37. So its answer is 37. In decimal. Right? It is clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. One more. Okay. Let's take one more example. Okay. I have here 011110. Okay. What is its equivalent thing? So 0, 1, 1. So what is there? 16 is there. 8 is there. 4 is there. 2 is
30.
There.
16 30.
Plus
8. 30.
Plus 4 plus 2. Okay. So
30.
16 plus 8 is 24. 20 is 30. So 30. Answer is 30. Right. So in short, we can find out. Right. I guess all of you understood how to convert binary to decimal in a quicker way. Right. In a quicker way.
The number of zeros and ones, we will just increase the 2 power value, no, sir?
Yeah, 2 power value. 2 power value.
Yes.
Okay. So, easily we can find. This is a quick conversion process, right? Without help of calculator and the long arithmetic, what we have been doing, directly we can find, right? So, let's take to a 3-bit thing. Okay. So, 3-bit, let's say I have 3 bit means 3 digits I have, So if I have 3 bits, how many values are possible? Let's say 3 bits, I can write 000. Okay, then I can write 001, 010, 011, 100. Okay,
7.
1010. Okay, 111. So let's answer this. Okay, what is 3 zeros? 3 zeros means what? Okay, 3 zeros means
0.
This is 1, 2, 4. Okay, so it is 0. This is 1. This is 2. This is 3. This is 4. Right? 5. This is 6. This is
7.
So only if you have 3 binary bits or 3 digits, how many values are possible? The answer is 2 power 3. 8 values are possible. What are those values? These are those values. Okay. 8 values are there, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, these are total 8 values. So if you go, okay, let's do it for 2 bits. Okay, let's do it for 2 bits. So what you will get if 2 bits are there, 2 bits taken together, how many digits are possible?
3,
4.
So 0, 0 is possible.
4.
1 is possible, 1, 0 is possible, and 1, 1 is possible. Okay, right. So what do we mean by 0, 0? 0, 0 means decimal value is 0. 1 means 1. 1, 0 means 2. 1, 1 means 3. Okay. So you should remember this. This is an important table. Okay. This is an important table. Right. 0, 0 means decimal equivalent is 0. Okay. 0, 1 means decimal equivalent 1. 1, 0 means 2. Okay. 1, 1 means 3. Right now, yesterday I asked you to read a statement, right? 4, 5, you could read it on the screen. Okay, so most of you have read it. There are, let me show it. Okay,
yes, sir. There are two types of people. Yes, sir, I got it.
Yeah, now you can control what was better. Now you can read it correctly. So yesterday, people have read it, 10 types of people in the world, those who know it and those who. Do not. It's that type. It's yeah. It's not 10 type. Okay, it's 2 type. There are 2 types of people in the world. Those who understand binary and those who do not. Right. So, is my voice clear now? Yeah. Right. We can make 4 different words, okay, or 4 different values in binary. If you take 3 bits, 8 different things are possible. If you take 4 bits, 16 different things are possible. Okay, let me note it for 4 bits. If 4 bits taken together, 16 numbers, we call communication, we call it as symbols. Number of binary bits taken together, we call it as a symbol. Okay, so 2 bits taken together, 4 symbols, 2 bits taken together, 4 symbols are possible. If you take 3 bits together, 8 symbols are possible. Right? Your audio is not clear. Is my audio clear?
So it's better now, sir, but in between it's breaking, sir.
Yeah, there is some network issue here, I guess. Okay, I guess the screen is visible now. Okay. Okay, if we take 4 binary bits together, 16 symbols are possible. So let's try it. So it is 0000 is the first symbol. Okay, 0001 is the second symbol. 0010 is the third symbol, and 0011 is the fourth symbol, right? Similarly, let's write the next four symbols. Okay, so it is 0100 0101 0110 0111. You see what is changing here? Okay.
Yes, sir. Two
power. Let's note it. So, these are same. Okay.
Yes, sir.
These are same. All of you mark. Okay. How you can write? Right. So I am changing 1 bit here. 0101. This is same. This is 0. This is 1. Okay. Right. So always remember using two binary bits. What we can write? 0001 10 and 11. Okay. So similarly, four bits taken together. These are eight symbols. Still eight more symbols we can add. Okay. So let me write. This is 1000. Okay. 1001 1010 1011. Okay. So this is 12. Now we 1101 1110 1111. It's clear. Okay. 16 yes, symbols are possible if you take four binary bits together. Okay. If you take four binary bits together, 16 symbols are possible. Okay. Let me write its equivalent. You people can write its equivalent decimal value. How? Put the 1248 formula. Okay. I'm writing in the red color. Right. So this is four zeros. Means what? All values are zero. So decimal equivalent is zero. Okay. So this is 1248 formula. 1248. So for the second one, you people can say, write yourself. Second one, this is 1. Okay, the answer will be 1. Rest all are 0. For the third one,
2.
For two. The third one,
2.
It's 2. Okay, for the fourth one,
3.
Okay, this one. 2 plus 1, 3. Okay, right. Similarly, if you come here, what you will get? It's 1248. What is the answer?
4.
1248. Okay, the answer is 4. I'm writing here. Okay. And for this,
5.
What will be the answer?
5.
It's 5. Yeah, let's move to the next one. This is 0110. It is 6. The next one will be, sorry. Next one will be
7.
Okay. So similarly, this will be 8. This is 8. This is 9. This is 10. This is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. 0 to 15. There are 16 symbols possible. Right? There are 16 symbols possible. I guess all of you are clear. If you take two binary bits together, you can make four symbols. If you take three binary bits together, you can make eight symbols. If you take four binary bits together, you can make 16 symbols. The corresponding decimal values, how easy you can find out? Find it out. Right? I will explain how easily you can find it out without going through the traditional method. Right, using the 1248. Okay. So let's move to the arithmetics. Okay, let's move to the arithmetics now. I guess this is to all of you. Shall I move ahead?
Yes, sir.
Anyone having doubt? Anyone have doubt up to this point? Then I'm moving. Let's go to okay. So if you add two binary numbers, what is like in decimal, you have 10 distinct digits. Okay, so some of those, you know, like 1 plus 2, what will happen? 1 plus 3, what will happen? 1 plus 4, what will happen? Okay, last thing is there. But in binary, how many digits are there? Only 2, zeros and 1. Okay, 0 and 1. So we have 2 digits only, and let's say we are going to add them 0 plus 0. Okay, if you add 0 with 0, what will be the sum? Sum 0. Okay, so we have a component called as sum. We have another component called as carry. Okay? Right? We have another component called as carry. So sum is 0, carry is also 0. Right? So this is binary 0 plus binary 0. So binary equivalent or decimal equivalent of 0. Binary 0 is how much? 0 only. 0 plus 0 is 0. Carry is 0. Right? Now let's see. 0 plus 1. Sum is 1. Carry is 0. 1 plus 0. Sum is 1. Carry is 0. Okay. 1 plus 1. Okay. 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1.
Anyone
having any
sum 0 carry 1?
0 1.
Right. Yeah. 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1. What is the sum? 1.
0.
1 plus 1. This is binary 1. Okay. Binary 1. Binary 1 means decimal equivalent is how much? Decimal equivalent, how much?
2.
Decimal equivalent is also 1. Its decimal equivalent is also 1. So 1 plus 1 answer is, in decimal it is 2. Right. What is the binary equivalent of 2? 2 means what? How 2 is
one
represented?
1, 0.
1, 0. So 1 plus 1, sum is 0.
0.
Yeah. Carry is 1. Sum is 0. Carry is 1. Understood? Sum is 0. Carry is 1. So this table you have to remember.
Can you explain the
table? This table you have to remember.
Sir, what is meant by carry?
0. What is meant by carry? So if you add 5 plus 5, how much in decimal?
10.
One, right? So, what do you do? 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay. While we go on adding many digits numbers, let's say 15 plus 25 you do. So, you add the 5 plus 5 first. What you get? 10. What you write on the below? You write 0 and
carry over, sir. Carry over. Okay, sir.
That is carry here. Okay. 0 plus 0, it is sum is 0, carry is 0. 0 plus 1, sum is 1, carry is 0. 1 plus 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. 1 plus 1, sum is 0, carry is. Okay. So we are looking into the binary arithmetic. Okay. I'm correlating it with decimal thing what we know. Right.
Okay.
So 1 plus
carry
1
column, the left side
2. In decimal.
Yes, sir. The left bit will be in the carry column, sir.
Yeah, left bit will be the carry column.
Yes, sir.
We call it as most significant bit. This one, we call it as most significant bit. We call it as least significant bit. Okay? Right. This is an analogy I have explained by comparing it with the decimal system, right? So 1 plus 1 in decimal it is 2. This 1 is in base 10. This 1 is in base 10. Okay. This answer 2 is in base 10. But this answer, this 1 is in base 2. This is base 2. This answer is in base 2. Okay. Right. So this 2, if you write,
sum is 2. Okay, carry is 0. So you have carry 0 right here and sum is 2. Understood? In decimal. This is in decimal. Okay? But if you write it in binary, you get it as a 0. You get carry as 1. Okay? All of you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's add two number. It will be clear to you. Okay? Let's add two number. Decimal equivalent also we will see. And simple addition I am giving. You people can try yourself also. Add. Binary numbers. Add two binary numbers. Okay. So these two numbers I have given 100101. This is one number. Another number 10101. Okay. Now add these two. So what do we do? How to do it? We'll say, let's start from the LSB side. 1 plus 1. This 1 plus this 1. Okay, 1 plus 1 is how much?
0.
Sum 0.
0.
Carry 1. This is sum 0. Carry is?
1.
Okay. Now, this carry is there. 1 plus 0 plus 0. It's 1. Now again, 1 plus 1, it's 0.
0.
0.
And have 1.
1.
1.
1.
1. 1. Right? Understood?
Yes.
So let's see, by converting it into decimal thing. Okay. If you convert 100101, what is its decimal value? What is its decimal value? Put in the 1248 formula. So this is 1 plus 4. Okay. So 1 exists. 4 exists. Then after 4 you have 18, 8, 16, 32. Okay. This is 32.
37, sir.
Okay. Plus 4. Plus 1. How much?
37 plus 21, 58. 21, sir.
So how much you are getting this?
58.
It's coming correct, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In this way, you can verify.
58, yes, sir.
58, right? I didn't calculate. So people can calculate. Okay. You can check the values in calculator quickly, right? So let's move to another example. Let's move to another example. Let's add 11111 with 111. What do we get?
0101.
This is 110, sum 0, carry 1. Now what is happening? 1 plus 1 plus 1. What will be the answer? 1 plus 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is how much?
Someone carry one.
Okay. So let me tell, this is 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 10. Okay. Or 10. Okay. 1 plus 1 is 10. In decimal, 1 plus 1 is how much? 2. 2 means what? 10. Okay. So 10 plus 1 is 11. That is 3. Right. So sum is 1. Carry is 1. Again, 1 plus 1 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 1. Carry 1. So 11. 0, carry 1, 11, 0, carry. This is the answer. All of you understood?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to everyone, yes, this example?
Yes, sir.
Or want to do it again?
Yes, sir. The carry over addition, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Right? So its equivalent value is 31, I guess. Its equivalent value is 7, I guess. And this one you will get how much? This is 32, 1, 2, 4, 32, 4, 36 to 38.
38.
Right. Let me write one. So how to know this is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So 32. 32 exist, 4 exist, 2 exist. So 32 plus 4 plus 2 is 38. Okay?
It's clear?
Yes, sir.
I go. Any sort of addition you can do now in binary. Okay?
Yeah, can you explain the above example again? Right. Okay. Let's do it again. Okay. You people got confused. Let's do it again. I have 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay. And I would like to add 1, 1, 1. Right. So before doing it again, let's understand this 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. And 1 plus 1. Is 10. Okay, it's not 10. You should not read 10. It's 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay, 1 plus 1 is 2. What is 1 0? It's 2. Means what? This is the sum. This is the carry. Okay, is this now what happens when you write 1 plus 1 plus 1? Okay, 1 plus 1 plus 1. So add these two. These all ones are in binary. Okay. Not decimal ones. So 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 how much? It's
1 0 plus 1.
1 0 plus 1. 1 0 plus 1 is how much?
1 1.
Let me put it in this way. 1 0 plus 1. How much?
1 1.
So this is sum. This one. And this one is carry. So sum is 1. Carry is 1. Okay. Now let's take this example again. All of you are clear? 1 plus 1 plus 1. Sum is 1. Carry is 1. Sum is 1. Carry is 1. Okay. So now let's go to this example. How we can do it. Okay. One plus one. This is addition. 1 plus 1. It's 0. Okay. Carry is 1. Let me write the carry here. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. Sum 1, carry 1. Okay. 1 plus 1 plus 1. Sum 1, carry 1. 1 plus 1. 0, carry 1. 1, 1. 0, carry 1. This is the answer. Its equivalent values I have written. This is 31. This is 7. And its equivalent value, if you find out, it is how much? 38. So how to get 38? This is 2 power 0. This is 1, 2, 4. 8, 16, 32. This is the formula. Right. So, what things exist here? 32 is there. Okay. This is 4 is there. 2 is there. If you sum them, 32 plus 4 plus 2 is 38. Yeah, 42. Is it clear to you? B9, 42. 64.
Is it clear to you both?
I would like to listen from 42. Is it clear? B9 42.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. Shall we move ahead to another example?
Yes,
okay, so I think summation it's enough, right? Let's move to the subtraction part, which is more difficult for many students. Okay, I will make it much simpler. But you should remember these logics what I have told for summation, right? Let's move to subtraction. I'm writing in sort. Okay, binary subtraction. So, like sum and carry, here we have two things. Okay, the subtracted value and borrow. Right. So let me show it in the table. Right. The slide. See, this is the addition one. What we have already seen. Okay, this is the subtraction. So 0 minus 0. What is the answer? 0. Okay, 0 minus 0. The answer is 0, and borrow is 0. Similarly, 0 minus 1. Okay, the answer is 0. Borrow is 1. Okay, this is important to understand, right? 1 minus 0, it's okay, it's 1. 1 minus 1, it's 0, right? The only thing here to understand is the second one. Okay, we are subtracting a value 1 from 0. Then what will happen? Like, if you subtract a larger value from a smaller value, you borrow something in decimal, right? You borrow from the neighbor fellow. Okay, neighbor fellow will borrow you 10. And from that, you subtract it and get the answer. Okay. So, let's try the subtraction operation, okay, in binary. Okay. I'll take out a few examples. Then it will be clear to you. Let's take a simple subtraction. Subtract 1001. You can subtract 001. A simple one. Okay. What you will get?
One.
What you will get?
Zero.
It is 1 minus 1. This is 0. Okay. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 0, 0. This is 1. What is its equivalent value? This is 1248. So 819. What is its equivalent value? 1. So 9 minus 1, it should have been 8. It's correct, right? 1248. This answer is 8. So it's correct. Okay, this is a simple subtraction. Okay. Now let's move to another example. Okay, let's move to another example. So I would like to subtract 13. This is, I have written in decimal, see, 7. Okay, what should have been the answer? 13 minus 7, it should be 6, right, in decimal. Okay, let's try it in binary form. Okay, let's try it in binary form. What is equivalent binary value of 13? It's 1101, right? 8 4 12 1 13, right? 1101 minus, what is 7? 0 1 1 1. So if you subtract this, you get 6. Let's try this. Okay, 1101. Let me write little below. 1101, and I would like to subtract this. Okay, can you do it? 1 minus 1.
0.
0.
What do you get?
0.
0. 0 minus 1. Is it possible? All of you look here carefully. 0 minus 1, it's not possible, right?
No.
So 0 minus 1.
0.
This
zero.
Fellow should zero. Borrow to the neighbor fellow. Okay. So what this fellow will do, it will ask the neighbor fellow. Okay. I am not in to subtract. Please borrow me 1. Okay. So this neighbor fellow is going to give this fellow 1. Okay. And it becomes 0. Right? It becomes 0.
Yes,
now the subtraction will begin. Now what will
zero,
be the answer? 1, 0.
Zero.
What is the equivalent zero. Value is 1,
0? 0.
No, it's 0. It's not 0. 1, 0. What is the decimal equivalent?
1, sir.
Yes, sir. 1, sir.
1, 0 means
2. Okay.
2, sir.
1, 2, 2, decimal 2, value
2. 2.
2. 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay?
1.
Yeah. So 1, 0 minus 1 is 1. Right, if you can remember, yes. We have written 1 plus 1 is equal to this. Okay, so if you subtract, what you will get?
1. Yes, sir.
Yeah, we got it 1. Right, now look to the third this point. So 0 minus 1, again it's not possible. So this
1.
Fellow will ask this fellow, I am not in a position to subtract, please borrow me 1. So this is 1. 1 0. 1 0 minus 1, it's 1. So what is the answer?
1 1
0. Okay, what is its decimal equivalent?
is 1 2 4 4 2 6.
Six.
Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
All of you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyone having doubt?
No, sir.
Yeah. Let's move to another example. Okay. Let's move to another example. Okay. And see whether you are in a position to do it or not. Okay. So, I would like to subtract a value 58 in decimal, okay, minus 35 decimal, okay. So equivalent binary values I am writing here. Okay, 58 means 1 1 1 0 1 0. Okay, let me write little order. It's 1 1 1 0 1 0. Okay, and 35 you can calculate 1 0 1 1. Okay, now let's do the subtraction. Okay, how to do it now?
Borrow one.
Okay. 0 minus 1, not possible. This fellow
borrows.
Is going to ask this fellow, okay, give me 1. I would like to subtract. So after giving 1, this fellow becomes 0. Okay? So it is 10 minus 1. 1.
1.
Okay. 10 means 2 minus 1. 1. Right? Now 0 minus 1, not possible. This fellow again asks this fellow, please give me if you have 1. But this fellow tells, I also don't have. Let me ask. This fellow asks this fellow. Okay. So what will happen now? This one gives 1 to this fellow and becomes 0 for itself. Now this is 2. 1 0 means what? 1 0 means 2. Okay. So out of this 2, this fellow gives 1. This fellow gives 1 to here. Okay, this fellow give 1 to here. Out of this 2, this fellow give 1 and retain 1 with him. This is not there. Okay, now you subtract. This is 1 0 minus 1. 1 0 minus 1, how much?
0.
1.
2 minus 1, 1. Okay, 1 minus 0. Sorry, this is 1. Okay, 0 minus 0.
0.
This is 1. 0. This is the answer, right? Yeah, what is its equivalent value? This is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16.
7.
Okay, 16.
20.
Plus 4, 20, 22, 23.
23.
Okay, 23. If you remember 58 minus 35, what is the answer?
23.
23. Is it clear? Is it clear to you people how to do subtraction?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. One more example. Okay. And I expect you to. One more example I am taking. Subtract 82 decimal value minus 63. Okay. Answer should come 19. You people should verify by taking a decimal. So let me write 82. Okay, let me write 82. 82 means what? Okay, all of you note it down. 82 means 1 0 1 0 0 1 0. Okay.
1 0.
63 means this is all 1. Okay. Now let's do this. Okay, let's do the subtraction and see what we are getting. Can say, let me ask someone.
Roll number 20, B9. Unmute yourself. Roll number 20, B9.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Help us to do this. Yeah, 0 minus 1, it will be?
1.
1.
Yes, sir.
You have to take borrow, right?
Yes, sir.
You have to take borrow. Others do find it yourself. Okay. I'm seeing. So, yeah, help me to do. First, I will ask borrow because it is not possible from subtract 1 from 0, right? So, this fellow will ask this fellow. Please give me 1. So, after giving 1, this becomes 0. So, this is 10 minus 1. How much?
1.
1, 0 minus 1. 1. Okay. Now, here 0 minus 1. Is it possible?
No, so we need to borrow.
Not possible. So, you borrow from this fellow also don't have. It will borrow from here. This also don't have. It will borrow from here. Okay? We'll borrow from here. What it will get? It will get a 1. So this itself becomes 0. So out of 2, this fellow retains 1 with him. Okay? And gives 1 to this fellow. Out of this 2, 1, 0 is 2. This fellow retains 1 with him and gives 1 to this fellow. So this is 10 minus 1. Or 2 minus 1 is 1. This is 1 minus 1, 0. Okay? 1 minus 1, 0. This is 1 minus 1, 0.
0.
Okay. This is how much?
0 minus 1.
0 minus 1. Not possible. It should ask here.
We need to borrow.
It should ask here. Okay. This fellow gives 10. And out of 2, this fellow retains 1 and gives 1 to here. So this is 1.
1.
This is 0. What is the equivalent value? This is 16.
Plus 2. Plus 18. 0.
All of you got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
010011. Anyone having doubt?
Sir, at front there is no another 0, sir.
Here?
Yeah.
You can put. It doesn't matter. Wherever 1 is there, we will take those values. Right. So, writing 10011 and appending 0 towards MSP doesn't make any sense. If you append 0 towards LSP, it will change. Okay. Like putting 0 in front of 100 makes the value 100 only. If you put 0 towards the other end, it becomes 1000, 10,000. Same, similar way. Understand? Okay, so we will stop at this point, right? So it's 10 o'clock, I guess. I guess it's clear to all of you, right?
Yes, sir.
Do try subtraction of some other numbers of your choice. Okay, and okay. I instruct all of you to join Google Classroom today. 2 quizzes will be uploaded today for yesterday's class and today's class. You join Google Classroom with the code given and answer those quizzes by today night. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we are stopping here.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, is this problems provided in the material, sir?
No. This video will be uploaded. Okay, this video will be uploaded. The other things. Okay, material means I didn't make any material. Just follow this master and look the things from book. Okay.
Okay, sir.
It takes time to make material. Some later you will get it. See, attendance and.
Thank you, sir.
Is it done, sir? Can we leave?